Bam, it's true. Okay, I'm going to do a quick video here to showing you how to multiply complex numbers in polar form and divide. And it's a very, very straightforward process as long as you have these formulas, whether available to you or in memory. And then in the next video, introducing the Dumov's theorem and using that to find powers and roots, we're going to work on the product rule here a little bit to help prove where that rule comes from, at least for the products. Or excuse me, the powers. But for now, we're just going to run a couple examples and call it a day. So, I want to do the product one here, and to multiply two complex numbers in polar form, all you need to do is multiply the two radiuses together, and then multiply that by the cosine of the two angles being added, plus I times the sine of two angles again being added, and these are the same angles, so they'll of course be the same answer. So, we have z sub 1 is equal to 2 times the cosine of 20 plus I sine 20 degrees. And then z sub 2 is equal to 3 times the cosine of 190 degrees plus I sine of 190 degrees. And, like this formula shows, if you want to find what z sub 1 times z sub 2 is, just take the two radiuses, multiply them together. So 3 times 2 is 6, times cosine of the two angles being added. So that's going to be 20 plus 190 plus I sine of those same two angles being added again. And I'm running out of room here. So 20 plus 190, we'll just squeeze that in there. And 3 times 2 is 6. Times the cosine of 20 and 190 is 210. Plus I. Times the sine of 210. And I don't know why I wrapped that one in parentheses. So that's pretty much it. Just, if you want to multiply two complex numbers in polar form, multiply the radiuses and add those angle measures. That's it. If you want to put this back into, you know, for some reason, rectangular form, distribute the 6 and put 6 cosine of 210 in your calculator and 6 sine of 210. I just said put that in your calculator, 210 degrees on the unit circle. So, let's just do that because there's not much of these problems anyway. 6 cosine of 210 degrees plus I 6 sine of 210 degrees. The cosine of 210 is negative square root of 3 over 2 plus I sine of 210 is negative 1/2. So we have negative 3 square root of 3 plus or minus, because that's negative, half of 6 is 3. So, I don't know, just to remind you, if you want to go from polar form of a complex number into rectangular form, just work it out. You got to work! Okay, anyway, work it out. Let's do a quotient and cut this video off before I really start doing some bad songs. Actually, if I'm singing them, I guess probably all that. Z sub 1 is equal to 28 times the cosine of 5 pi over 6 plus I sine of 5 pi over 6. And z sub 2 is 7 times the cosine of 3 pi over 4 plus I sine of 3 pi over 4. Yes, polar form of complex numbers can be in either degrees or radians. It's no big deal either on which one you're using. And I want to find the difference of those two complex numbers in polar form. So, we're going to divide those radiuses and we're going to subtract those exponents. So, make sure you keep this in proper order, by the way, because when you subtract, of course, it's going to make a difference, right? Because 5 minus 3 is 2 and 3 minus 5 is negative 2. So don't, make sure you don't cause yourself any issues there getting that subtraction backwards. So I want to do z sub 1 divided by z sub 2. So that means we're going to do 28 divided by 7 times the cosine of the angle measure that goes along with the radius that you placed on the top of your quotient. This is R1 and it's theta 1 divided by theta 2, sub 2. So we're going to do 5 pi over 6 minus 3 pi over 4 plus I sine of, again, those same two angles in the proper order, 5 pi over 6 minus 3 pi over 4, and we get 4 times the cosine of, well, I'll just write this stuff out here. You can't subtract fractions unless, right, you have common denominators. So we're going to multiply this by the top and bottom with 2, and then top and bottom by 3. So we make that common denominator of 12, and we're going to get 5 times 2 is 10 pi over 12 minus 3 times 3 is 9 pi over 12 plus I times sine of, same thing, so 10 pi over 12 minus 9 pi over 12, and our final answer therefore is 4 times the cosine of 10 minus 9 is 1, so pi over 12 plus I sine of, again, pi over 12. I'm Mr. True, and that's the product and quotient of polar form of complex numbers. Woo! All right, bam! Go do your homework. Or watch my next video of the Dumas theorem.